You are listening to KLRN Radio, where liberty and reason still reign.
Most writers and radio show hosts know that to connect with your fans, you need to do more than just write books or record the latest podcasts. There are many different elements that go into forming an online platform, but there are also many hidden traps. To make matters worse, solid advice on how to survive the muddy waters is scarce. In the book Hidden Traps, I talk about some of the important issues of working with an online platform, highlighting traps that could put your physical or internet security at risk or be harmful to your reputation. Are your social media posts just links with a few disjointed words, making you look like someone who can't complete a sentence? Did your new website cost you more than you anticipated? Are you leaking your personal contact details across the web without even knowing it? Then you need Hidden Traps. Hidden Traps is now available in paperback and ebook from a variety of retailers, including Amazon, Barnes & Noble, and Kobo. Visit blackwolfpublications.com for more details.
Do you need a car? Been shopping only to be turned down because of bad credit, low credit, no credit, bankruptcy, or divorce? Guess what? Today's your lucky day, because now you can buy a car, truck, or SUV, just about any vehicle. It's true. Bad credit? Doesn't matter. No credit? Doesn't matter. Bankruptcy or divorce? It just doesn't matter. As a matter of fact, your job is your ticket to your new vehicle. We're Auto Credit Express, and we've helped thousands of people just like you. Antonio H. told us, great company, got me connected, and the day I went in, I drove off in the car I wanted. 100% worth your time. Need a car? Get started now and drive off as early as today. Just text FINANCE, FINANCE, to 357-911 right now to get started. That's FINANCE, FINANCE, to 357-911. Auto financing the easy way. Text FINANCE to 357-911.
KLRN Radio has advertising rates available. We have rates to fit almost any budget. Contact us at advertising@klrnradio.com.
Everyone loves liberty. Our rights come from God, not the government. So why are you letting other people tell you what's best for your health care? Exercise your freedom with Liberty Health Share. Liberty Health Share is a community of people who voluntarily share one another's medical costs. Liberty Health Share is founded on the idea that most people truly want to help one another. Healthcare sharing allows members to do just that as a true community that supports one another in times of need. Liberty believes people should make decisions for themselves and their families. Members are able to take back the freedom to make their own decisions about their health care. Freedom from guilt or doubt about how your money is used. You have the freedom to direct your health care, not to be dictated to by bureaucrats. Stop letting others tell you what to do and join a community of like-minded people. Exercise your freedom. Join Liberty HealthShare and take back the control of your health care while helping those around you. Call Liberty at 855-58-LIBERTY. Again, that's 855-58-LIBERTY for more information, or you can check them out at libertyhealthshare.org. Again, that's libertyhealthshare.org.
My son was in the Army back during Desert Storm. But even then, he wanted an MBA. He looked at a dozen schools, but only one offered the online education and flexibility he needed while he was in a tent in Iraq. Grantham University. Turns out that Grantham's been delivering affordable, relevant college and advanced degrees for over 65 years. Heck, if they can deliver a quality education to a soldier in a tent overseas, think about the flexibility Grantham can offer you so you can earn your degree too. It doesn't matter how complicated or full your life is, if getting a degree is on your bucket list, you'll want to do what my son did. You'll want to call Grantham. Find out how easy it is to get started on your education so you can check that college degree off your bucket list. Call Grantham right now, 800-910-1370. That's 800-910-1370. Flexible, affordable, relevant. Call 800-910-1370.
At St. Jude, a family never sees a bill at all. It's like the world has been lifted off of your shoulders.
St. Jude Children's Research Hospital, finding cures, saving children. Learn more at stjude.org.
Sometimes writers feel lost, unsure why a passage may not be working. takes another set of eyes to help us nurture our writing into full maturity. At Black Wolf Editorial Services, we strive to enable writers to develop and grow, offering manuscript critiques and line edits through a mentoring editorial style. We also offer assistance on generating a writer's bio for your websites. Black Wolf Editorial Services, nurturing your writing into maturity. For a full list of services, visit blackwolfeditorial.com.
You're listening to the Spark Radio Network, internet radio like you've never heard before. Innovation, creativity, and imagination are all said to begin with a spark. So fasten your seatbelt and take the ride of your life and listen for the spark.
The following program contains coarse language and adult themes. Listener discretion is advised.
Toxic masculinity.
You threw me off, G. You kind of paused for a second there. Go ahead.
I think we're all ready to jump in there.
Well, you know, like I said, it was a month ago, so I don't remember shit. anyway, it's great to be back here with you. I am with my esteemed co-hosts. Let's see. We'll do it alphabetically this time. Ordy Packard and Rowdy Rick.
Well, hi guys.
Welcome back.
Welcome. This is the second episode of Toxic Masculinity. Hope everybody's having a great Wednesday. And we have our official first ever babe of the month with us this evening too.
Yes. That's right. We do. And Rick, you are actually responsible for booking this Uber talent, so we're going to allow you the introduction.
Well, for those of you who don't know who she is, where the hell have you been? We have the one, the only, you know, on Twitter as L.A. Dowd. She's actually the voice behind the disclaimer that you just heard at the beginning of the program. She's a fill-in host on KLRN Radio. She's actually been part of a podcast back when we were branded under K98 Talk. And she is with us tonight, so I'm going to let her finish the introduction, because who better to tell you about her than her? Good evening, Miss Leslie. How are you?
Gentlemen.
Okay. It hasn't been proven in court.
Hello, my babies. Thank you. It's my great honor to be the inaugural babe of the month.
Oh, yeah. I like the sound of that.
It's like I said. It's like I said on Twitter. Unlike the Dems in Congress, we lead with the best. Just saying.
It's my great honor, and I really loved your pilot episode last month. And I'm super excited to join you tonight and to join you with, we'll talk about this later, but we know that we're going to be making a complimentary, binary complimentary podcast, but we'll talk about that later. But it's my honor to be with you guys.
It's our honor to have you. So just in case we have folks that have maybe are tuning in for the first time or have been hiding under rocks for the time that you've been on other shows and other capacities, things like that, why don't you tell folks a little bit about yourselves and how in the heck you got started in this crazy world we call podcasting?
Well, God leads me. God leads me in everything. I got into conservative political activism right around early 2012. I was blessed. I'm living here in the cradle of liberty, which is kind of becoming the cradle of socialism little by little in Massachusetts. But I was blessed with some lovely talk radio, local talk radio hosts back in the early 2000s, late 90s, early 2000s, and got more interested in politics around the, you know, starting when into the Obama administration. And as I was talking to Ordy earlier, you know, if you're not interested in politics, politics is going to be interested in you, you know. And then I got into Twitter through other friends that started getting into Twitter. And then I learned about Andrew Breitbart, started meeting people that really changed the paradigm of what it means to be a conservative. It's not really about Republican or Democrat anymore. It's about what are your values? What do you think about freedom? What do you think about the role of government? What do you think about the role of capitalism versus other ways of dealing with an economy? And my eyes were completely opened when I joined Twitter. And as you and I talked about, Ricky, in my guest appearance with you, thank you very much, last week, around here, you have to be so tight in your knowledge and your conversation, because we're just here in you know, the Democrat entrenched Kennedy bunkers, Kennedy Elizabeth Warren bunkers, that you have mm-hmm. to be the one, you have to be the one to disrupt the narrative, because these people around here just accept everything as it is. And when you come up and challenge them, you have to have all of your facts, your information on point. And that's what I learned. I lived a whole life being intimidated to talk to anybody if I had a different opinion, because everybody's so smug and so assuming. Then I got on Twitter. I'm like, oh, wait a minute. No, here's the real facts. Here's the reality in the world. Now you come back to your local life, to people that are either asleep or smug. And then you say, okay, now I am going to talk to you. I am going to confront you, because now I have all the facts. And I can hit this with you all day long. And it changed my life. It changed my life. And here I am in 2019, still working to save the Republic. In terms of the podcasting, I was that's not a big story. Very grateful to meet a lot of lovely friends on Twitter, to do various voice work, various podcasting appearances, guest appearances. Briefly had my own show by the grace of Rick to produce it, my own show with a co-host by the grace of Rick to produce it. And it's like, I am here to save the Republic. It's fun, but it's not fun. I would rather that none of us have to do this to try to save the Republic. But if we're going to do it, let's have some fun.
No, well, you're in exactly. Massachusetts. You've got to save the Republic from Brianna Wu.
Oh, did we have to bring her up already? I already had issues when somebody showed me some of the other things that were actually tied to the Babe of the Month hashtag, and you just had to go with and bring up Brianna Wu.
Sorry.
Ugh. But hey, since we're on the subject of crazy guys, I just thought you'd like to know that Alex Jones and Joe Rogan are trending because the former is on the Ladders podcast talking right. about aliens making human-animal hybrids.
Well, they have a base in San Francisco.
Well, go figure.
You guys, I saw that episode of South Park. It's fine.
Right. I was going to say, I thought I saw that on South Park.
But, you
Yeah, that was the least surprising thing of Jones's rant, that there was an alien base in San Francisco. I was like, well, yeah, duh.
Since the 60s. Yeah. Where do you think acid rock came from?
So wait,
city is such a shithole.
So just to make sure, because you know it's been a long day, and I've been hip deep in congressional hearings, because I was actually scheduled off from the day job today, so I was actually following along with that stuff when I was in and out of the couple of meetings that I had scheduled for today. So just to clarify, who was actually on whom's podcast?
Alex Jones was on Joe Rogan's podcast.
Okay, I was just checking because yeah, there's a small station that I used to be affiliated with in the Jersey area that actually runs Alex Jones live during the day now. And I was like, oh, I used to like you guys.
Somebody has the gall to broadcast him.
Apparently. You know, he wasn't bad when he was a guest on Art Bell all the time. But yes, we can blame Art Bell for legitimizing Alex Jones.
Why not? What the hell, right?
We're going to blame somebody that isn't me. Let's blame.
That's right. That's right. Let's blame Patriot Musket. He's not here.
Yeah, exactly.
He's probably listening right now, though.
That's funny.
Or will be when
he's. Well, that's okay, because he got blamed for something earlier, and he'll take this too.
Whatever. I love him.
Patriot Musket gets blamed for everything.
That's great. Hey, you know what? By the way, something new this month that we didn't have last month. We actually have a call-in line now.
Oh, so good.
Yeah. Yeah, it's actually 1-976. No, I'm kidding.
please, Grouchy, please.
$3 for the first minute.
Who's talking, Horty or Grouchy? Because I can't tell you guys apart by voice yet.
This is G now.
All right, G, please.
So anyway,
please put a porn line.
Participant on this Hooper
please put a phone sex line for like the first just tonight and see who does it.
Oh, nice.
Okay, so the number is 976. I don't have a phone in front of me, so I don't know what that works out to on the number.
I know.
976 Grouchy X, and it's only $2.99
a minute.
The first minute.
For the first minute. And then it's like $99.99 a minute.
Well, if you want the happy ending, it is.
Yeah.
We're just going right into the Robert Kraft thing, aren't we?
Might as well.
We talked about Patriot, and now we're talking about Happy. I got to talk about Robert Kraft.
Okay, let's give the number out first, since we're wrong. Let's actually get that out there for the folks. Okay, listen up, folks. Write it down, because you're going to want to remember this. It's 405-266-1591. That's 405-266-1591. And we reserve the right to hang up on your dumb ass at will.
Wait, is that the actual number?
Yeah,
that is the number.
That's the actual number.
I would just 405. That's okay.
Yeah, that's right. That's where I live, dude.
I'm pretty sure that's a North Vietnam area code. North Korea area code.
That would be impossible.
Yeah, no, if we're doing Vietnam, then we got to talk about mines. All right,
back on track.
Back on track. Okay, yeah. Anyway.
We only have an hour. Let's do this.
Did anybody call?
No, they haven't called yet.
I feel like Alec Baldwin when he did his talk radio in New York. Do we have any callers yet? No.
Please clap.
Like Jeb Bush? Yeah, please clap. I was thinking it too.
All right.
Back on track.
Back on track.
What do you guys want to do?
Well, I'm going to do the Robert Kraft thing since we already have the happy ending. Okay. This is dumb, and I'll tell you why. For those of you who don't know, the owner of the Patriots last week got busted at a rub and tug down in Jupiter, Florida. And, okay, rich people. I don't know how many of you listen to the show. It's a 3-hour flight from New England to Florida. It is a five-hour flight to Nevada where this is legal. They have private entrances for celebrities. You can, there's a dozen of these places that you're not going to get arrested in. It's legal. Stop doing this dumb shit and getting caught. Okay, this is dumb. Why do you do this?
TSA 472.
I mean, I just, it doesn't make sense to me. I mean, we've all seen the movie Cat, or they all seen the TV show Cat House. It's you know.
No, we all haven't, but whatever. Okay.
you are aware that it exists though, right? That there was this TV show on HBO that, okay, anyway.
No, but whatever.
Anyway, it's legal in Nevada. It's legal. No, you're not going to get arrested. Stop doing this. I do have a question. Sure.
In Nevada, will they rub you wrong time like they do in Florida?
However much you want to pay for.
All right.
Okay. Yeah. No, I mean, okay. I thought that this story was going to be worse because when he got busted, that was part of a prostitution ring that was also part of a human trafficking ring. And I thought that that was going to end up being a much worse story than it ended up being for Robert Kraft. I mean, it's still a terrible story, sure. But for, you know, he wasn't caught with like some 12-year-old. It was just, he was just there for the happy ending.
Right.
So, but yeah, you can fly to Nevada. You have a private jet. It's 2 hours more. Nobody's.
Let's have sex. All right, Grouchy, what's your opinion?
Well, I mean, I'm just thinking out loud. He's like 80 years old, right?
77. Yeah.
77. His live-in is like half his age, right?
I don't
sure.
Why are we going to these things to start with?
But whatever. Continue.
I'm just thinking, why are we going to these places to begin with if you've got somebody half your age shacked up with you?
Yeah. I don't know. I mean, your name is Kraft and you own the Patriots. How much more power or money do you need?
Ricky, Leslie, your opinion.
Well, actually, I kind of got called out on Twitter because I tried to make a joke about the headline, and then I was advised that it involved human trafficking. So I'm not sure if I should give my opinion, but my gut reaction,
your show, dude.
My gut reaction when I saw the headline was, "Did he pay with a check?" Asking for a former Cincinnati mayor.
No, because he's a smart man.
Cash or Bitcoin in these transactions. That goes with Jesse Smalley. That goes with, I mean, in Jerry Springer's defense, they didn't have Bitcoin, but use cash.
Yes, or Venmo.
or Venmo, yeah. Something.
But yeah, I mean, and then the human trafficking angle came out. But that's another thing. I think for somebody that's got that much influence and that much money, it has to be about the power of it somehow.
Okay.
No, go ahead.
Forgive
Leslie,
me.
Leslie, what's your opinion?
No, go ahead.
Forgive me. I have an opinion about this podcast more than I have an opinion about this event. Okay. I kind of can't believe that we're on the Toxic Masculinity podcast. And you all are pearl clutching about this situation with an old man who had chosen some things. And of course, there's a little bit to talk about. There's a little bit here to talk about, but we're already on our like sixth or seventh minute for you guys. You guys are actually judging the rich old man.
Well, actually, we're just judging his
choice. Are you interrupting me?
No,
you're judging the rich old man.
I'm about to mansplain you.
We are on the once a month Toxic Masculinity podcast, and we're doing a whole segment of you guys judging the rich old man who makes gazillions of dollars to charity, and his choice of as a single man. For his choice for entertainment, and this is what you want to do for a good 15 minutes in the Toxic Masculinity podcast.
Did you just pun that?
I think she did. I'm judging the wisdom.
Exactly. Exactly.
I'm just.
Here's the wisdom. I'm sorry. Who's the guest? Here's the wisdom. My mother is the wisdom, because you all saw my tweet. Right? Like, my mom, you know, I have listeners. I have three entertaining hashtags in my profile, and the most entertaining one is hashtag cable news with mom, because I spend a lot of time with my octogenarian beloved mother, who is very funny. And so when she says funny things, I put it on Twitter, and I didn't know until yesterday how libertarian she is about the massage business. Never had occasion to talk to her about that in my life. But now you bring in Bob Kraft. Now she has a lot to say about her libertarianism in the massage business. And she says, Bob, did you have to put your Bentley in the parking lot of this Florida place? Bob, yeah, did you have to put your Bentley up in there?
The Bentley. I wonder if that's a pun, too.
That sounds punish.
I don't know.
At his age, Bentley.
I don't know if it was a pun or not, but it was rather punny.
Right. But anyway, it's like, look, man, just leave people alone. And I respect what y'all are saying about, like, okay, well, it's legal in Vegas, but in Florida, it's as legal as the sanctuary cities, right? It's not legal, but everybody knows it goes on. And if you're a libertarian, then I have mixed feelings about the trade, about this business, you know, because I think consenting adults should be allowed legally to trade, to barter, right. To barter, if you will. And of course, then you crack down and you make sure there's no children are trafficking involved. But I think, you know, leave the old man alone.
Well, and that's kind of, I'm 100% behind the legalization of it. I mean, it's, and Nevada, again, does it well because they get weekly checks. It's in a controlled environment, and I think Nevada is the model to do it. Nevada is still pretty weird on their law that you can't have a brothel in a town, in a county that has over 100,000 people. But, you know, yeah, I think Nevada is a good model for it.
But that's fine institutionally, but this is not what's going on right now. Why are you going to arrest people just for, as you all say, what's it called? What, a rub and tug?
Is that a rub and tug? Yeah.
Right.
Yeah.
It's just silly. It's silly. It's silly.
It's completely silly.
Yeah.
I agree.
Yeah. And I also have issue with the 15-minute thing.
What?
Because if you're done in 15 minutes, you are just a three-pump chump, and you need to get the hell out of the way and make room for a man.
Wait, what are we, what do you, what?
two occasions of 15 minutes is what they caught him on camera with.
Anyway. There was a camera?
Yeah, there was a camera.
Yes, there was. He is on video.
This is why it's a good thing Gawker isn't around anymore. That would be on.
Dogs were just in that. I don't know whose dogs we just caught on the mic, but that was perfect.
Oh, hey guys, guess what? We're bottom of the hour. Let's take a commercial break, and when we come back, we're either gonna. Did we actually just skip over Leslie's segment?
No.
I don't think we've actually officially done it yet, but we can give her an official few minutes when we come back. So,
all right, we'll do that officially when we come back, and then we're going to blow out some legs. So do yourself a favor and sit or go get.
We have lost control, folks. We'll be right back.
Not even in Nevada.
That's right. And it's going to take more than 15 minutes, too.
Yeah!
We've officially lost control, folks. We'll be back in about 3 minutes. Stay tuned.
My son was in the Army back during Desert Storm, but even then he wanted an MBA. He looked at a dozen schools, but only one offered the online education and flexibility he needed while he was in a tent in Iraq, Grantham University. Turns out that Grantham's been delivering affordable, relevant college and advanced degrees for over 65 years. Heck, if they can deliver a quality education to a soldier in a tent overseas, think about the flexibility Grantham can offer you so you can earn your degree too. It doesn't matter how complicated or full your life is, if getting a degree is on your bucket list, you'll want to do what my son did. You'll want to call Grantham. Find out how easy it is to get started on your education so you can check that college degree off your bucket list. Call Grantham right now. 800-910-1370. That's 800-910-1370. Flexible, affordable, relevant. Call 800-910-1370.
Attention business owners and independent contractors. This is a money-saving message from Tax Mediation Services. If your business owes $20,000 or more in taxes, we can help you today, right now. Listen, dealing with the IRS is no picnic. It's an intimidating and extremely stressful process, and you don't want to go it alone. Our attorneys know every law, every tax break, and every possible opportunity to help you resolve and reduce your tax debt. And if you owe more than $20,000, you may be at the top of their hit list. So don't take your tax debt lightly, because it will not go away on its own. The IRS can seize your bank accounts, your home, and even shut down your business. Call our tax experts today at 1-800-783-0810 and let us deal with the IRS while you focus on your business. That's 1-800-783-0810. Again, that's 800-783-0810.
Whether we realize it or not, everyone has been impacted by addiction. We all have family members, we all have friends that have faced this demon. But there's hope. There's hope in recovery. There's hope when we work together to rise above the plight of addiction. I'd like you to join Mac Mullings every Saturday from 2 to 4 p.m. on Rise Above Radio on KOKC 1520 AM, where they talk about the hope that is available to all of us.
Welcome back. I didn't want to miss the beat this time. I hope I didn't jump anybody there.
No, you're good.
That was last segment.
Okay. So great. Look, when we left off, we got a tie up here with Leslie. Leslie's going to be with us for the rest of the hour. Coming up at the top of the hour is Fubar. Ordy will be joining his co-host, or how shall we call her?
She's the host. I'm just the guy who makes fart noises.
There you go. On Fubar, up next, and then America Off the Rails with Rowdy Rick later tonight. But for right now, Leslie's going to tell us about something special.
Yes. Am I talking about our new project?
Yes, you
are. For KLRN?
Yes, you are.
Sure, yeah.
Okay, so I actually want Rick to introduce this, to talk about the foundation of this.
Okay, so what was it, about 2-3 weeks ago, we had actually planned on having Leslie on the Jen and Rick show, and then Jen had to bow out for work reasons, so she wound up filling in with me, and then the following time that we did a show, which I believe was that Thursday, we actually had all three of us on again, and it was one of those occasions where they basically ran the show for the entire hour. We got really great feedback on the fact that they were on the air together, so we'd been toying with the idea of them doing a show in common. And the idea was, because, you know, Jen's pretty busy right now. Leslie's got a new work thing going on, and I don't know when I would find any other time to be able to do much of anything else. So we decided, and Jen and I discussed it, and we're going to give up one of the time slots for the Jen and Rick show once every month to do a show that will basically, after some discussion, become a complimentary show to this one. And you were the one that came up with that idea, so why don't you fill everybody else in with what you came up with?
Right, so I'm very, very honored and grateful to come back into having like a regular show for podcasting. And I thought it was an amazing vibe to work with Jenny and you, Rick. And so we are going to do our once a month show as a compliment to the toxic masculinity. And Jenny and I are going to have our healthy femininity podcast.
Woo-hoo!
All right. Nice. Wait, did this spawn off of the boob show?
No.
Yes. Well, yes.
God, that was a great show.
Yeah, yeah it was.
Wait.
This is exactly where it came out of.
That was actually the one it did come from. I forgot. That was the one where I finally just gave up and started playing the clip from a sci-fi show I used to watch.
So wait a minute. Rick was actually part of the show, and he doesn't remember, but Ordy and I remember.
Yes, this is what spurned this idea.
I was concentrating on being professional while they were talking about boobs.
Oh, well, I was going to say, you should have been concentrating on what we were concentrating on.
Yeah, because that was a good show.
Yeah.
Which was what? Which was what?
Boobs.
Boobs. 20 minutes of you and Jen talking about boobs.
I think
it was utterly.
I think you guys are sort of distorting the actual content to whatever you were thinking about. I think the actual content was actually very, very high quality.
Well,
boobs are high quality.
What do you expect us to do with it? We're men.
Right, no, that's fantastic, exactly. Though. No, so are you going to be doing it the same week that we're doing the toxic masculinity?
Rick's in charge. No, I think it's probably going to be like the opposite weeks, right? Like the middle of the month. Like 2 weeks. I don't know. Rick's in charge.
That's going to be up to you two. Whatever you decide to do, that's fine with me. Just we'll set it up for once a month. Just you and Jen figure out what time frames kind of work best for you guys. With her schedule right now, for the next couple of months, we may have to alternate or something. But we'll try to get it as set as possible because she's coming into her busy season and her regular job. So,
right. Right. Damn, so the job. So I know. Amazing. Like Batman. So the idea for Jenny and I to just kind of do a once a month thing is healthy femininity, and just like you all are celebrating what's wonderful about men, we're going to celebrate what's wonderful about women, and I hope that we will also have a babe of the month guest for us as well, and just, you know,
oh hi,
just roll, just roll.
I
have a candidate for the inaugural Babe of the Month, Karachi.
You just say when. You just say when.
Mm-hmm.
Right after this drink.
Right.
Drink. Yeah, to hell with the drink.
All right, so that's that news.
All right, well, I like it. I'm down for whenever you just say the word. I'm there. Mm-hmm. We'll make it happen.
Okay, what's the next topic?
Next topic is the poll that was conducted. I put it out there. I asked everybody out there what they wanted to see from the gym next. We did shoulders last month, and 160 of you voted in this poll this month. Well, I gave 2 days, so we'll say this month, but 2 days, 160 votes, and legs won out. I was kind of surprised. I'm not going to lie. I didn't know that enough people actually knew how important legs were. But we're going to do my leg routine here real quick. So when you walk into the gym, you're going to get on the treadmill and you're going to do about 10 minutes of nice walking just to get the blood flowing and get warmed up. You're going to do this Well, if you're me, you're doing this with a 60-pound weighted vest on. So once the 10-minute warm-up is done, the first commandment of legs comes into play. And that commandment is, thou shalt not do squats on the Smith machine. So you're going to get your barbell, you're going to get your plates, and we're going to start off with a nice warm-up set, 15 reps at 135 pounds. And
I'm
sorry.
Why not on the Smith machine?
Because you need to be able to move freely. The Smith machine locks you into a track that may actually not be healthy for your back, your hips, or your knees.
Gotcha. You need to let your own body stabilize you with the weight.
Correct.
Gotcha.
So we're going to start off. The first set is 15 reps at 135 pounds, and you are going what we call ATG, that is ass to grass. So your butt is going to be nearly touching the ground. You're going to go that low, and then you're going to come back up, and you're going to do 15 of these. And then when you're done, you're going to set the bar down. You're going to take a little two-minute breather because this is going to take it out of you. You don't think it is at first, but it's going to take it out of you. Because the next set, you're going to 225 pounds. And then you're going to do 12 reps. And then the next set, 315 pounds for 10 reps. And then you're going to go to 365 pounds for 8 reps or until you can't do any more. And then you're going to take a nice 3 to 5 minute break, get some water, get your wind. You're going to be tired. I promise you, you're going to be tired. Next up, leg presses. Now, you have to make do with the equipment that's in your gym. I prefer a leg press machine. Yes, ma'am.
Can I raise my hand?
You may. Question?
All right. Why are we going below 90 degrees on the knees? For these squats, because why are we going below 90 degrees on these squats when we know that that's what is really taxing on the tendons on our knees?
Yes, ma'am, they are. But we do want maximum muscle engagement. And as long as your knees aren't like mine, if your knees are better than mine, you can go ass to grass, because if I can go ass to grass after 3 knee surgeries, 2 on the right and 1 on the left, then most people can.
Yeah, but you're saying yes, most people can, but why would you? When kind of the science says, why would you stress your joints over the 90 degrees? For limited gains.
Oh, but the gain is not just that limited, though. You're talking big differences in actual muscle between the fast twitch and the slow twitch. Going beyond 90 degrees activates so much more.
Gotcha. Okay, whatever you say.
I gotcha. Yeah, and now, hey, if going past 90 degrees is too uncomfortable for you, by all means, stop at 90. And if you need to use a chair to stop you at 90.
Yes, yes.
When your butt hits the chair, it's time to go back up.
Yes, that's right.
You can do that.
That's right.
But don't call me and say, I'm doing your leg routine and I'm using this chair and I'm stopping at 90 and my legs aren't getting any bigger.
Honey. Who's going to call you?
Oh,
who is going to call you and say on your toxic masculinity podcast, I'm not getting my gains?
I hope nobody.
Come on, man.
So look, next up, leg presses. We got to get this done.
All right, I'm shutting up.
Like I said, you got to use the equipment that's in your gym. I prefer a leg press that's on a 45-degree angle, so when you're looking at it from the side, it looks like a check mark.
Yes.
Okay? So we're going to put 225 pounds on this thing to start with, and we're going to do what's called a mega pyramid here. So 225 pounds, 20 reps. First set. Second set, you're going to 315 pounds for 15 reps. Okay, we're pyramiding down. The next set, 405 pounds for 12 reps. And the last, well, not the last set. The fourth set, 495 pounds for 10 reps. And then what you're going to do is you're going to start at that fourth set at 495 and do another set of 10 reps. And you're going to go backwards back up the pyramid while lowering the weights.
Yes, that's right.
Hey, G, we have a caller if you want to take them.
We got a caller.
Yep, we have a caller from Covington, Kentucky, from the looks of what I'm looking at right here. You should be able to
talk. You're on, caller from Covington.
Yeah, I was just wondering, after the treadmill part, what do you do while you're waiting for the ambulance to show up?
waiting for the ambulance, huh? That's good. 10 minutes on the treadmill and you're in the ambulance?
I probably would be. I'm not going to lie.
And we're just talking a warm-up walk here. I'm not talking about trying to run a marathon in 10 minutes.
That's right. That's right.
This is just to get the blood pumping.
That's right.
Well, you know, not all of us, you know, like can run like 50 miles in 3 minutes like certain people.
Hey, look, nobody starts at the finish line either. And that includes yours truly. You know, I didn't always do that. You have to work to it. That's just all there is to it. Boom. So anyway, we're done with leg presses. Next up in my routine would be walking lunges with dumbbells. And I like to find, if it's out in the parking lot, if that's what I have to do, I will do it. But I will get...
Yeah. Grouchy, because it looks weird in the gym.
Hey.
It looks weird in the gym, right?
All I'm looking for is someplace I can take 25 good long lunging strides in a straight path.
Alone.
Okay? Because, yeah, that first set, yeah. Girl, you are so right. It does look so weird. So anyway, my first set with lunges, with walking lunges, I do them with a pair of 50-pound dumbbells in my hands. And this is also wearing the weighted vest.
Uh-huh.
I use my weighted vest, so I believe in those things. I got 50 pounds in each hand. I got 60 pounds on my back. And I'm doing lunges. 25 down, 25 back is one set. You're going to do this three times, increasing the weight.
That was my bad.
Yeah, nothing. That's good. I saw it. That's fine. So anyway, we're going to do those lunges. Short break, water, catch your breath. You're tired. I guarantee you're tired. You're going to jump up on the leg extension machine. This is for your quads. Okay? So we're burning the quads up right now. And you're going to do three sets of 10 reps each, increasing the weight. I do 120, 150, and 180 on the leg extensions. And from there, because I know we're getting short on time, we're moving to Romanian or stiff-legged deadlifts. And this is a reverse pyramid. This is not a mega pyramid. I start off heavy because everything is already warmed up in my legs after these four exercises.
That's right.
So I'm going to start with 305 pounds for 10 reps with stiff-legged deadlifts, and I'm going to light those hamstrings up. Then in my next set, I'm going to go down to 275 for 12 reps, and then the next set, 225 for 15 reps. And I promise you, you're going to feel that, because right after that, you're going to get on the line leg curl machine, and you're also going to do a reverse pyramid.
So oh, Lord have mercy.
What's that? Yes, ma'am?
Lord have mercy. So you're saying They're going to get on the curl machine and do the hamstrings again.
Oh, yeah. Yeah. Right after the Romanian deadlift.
It is impossible.
You're going to start with 180 pounds for 10 reps.
It's impossible.
80 pounds for 12 reps and then 120 for 15 reps.
Yeah, sure they are.
And then we get to do my second favorite thing in the whole gym. We get to do calves after all that. Now, I like to do my calves really, really heavy. So, and I have posted video on Twitter of this before. You can see me doing calf raises with 800 pounds. That is out there. It is on my timeline. It's from.
Honey, we have 10 minutes.
What's that?
We have 10 minutes, so wrap it up.
Yeah, I know. So, you know, heavy calf raises, and then you're going to move to just doing it with just the weighted vest on a bar. You only need a couple inches of height to get your toes off the ground and your heels, and you're going to lower your heels to the floor and back up. And I'll do 5 sets of those, but I do them a little differently because I'll angle my toes inward for 20 reps.
That's right.
My toes outward for 20 reps, and then single leg straight for 10 reps on each leg, and that's a set. So that's 20, 40, 50, 60 calf raises is one set, and I'll do 5 sets of those.
That's right. You got to stretch. You're not talking at all, G, about the stretching in between the sets.
No, I'm not. No, I'm not, but I should be.
Stretching is important.
Stretching is important. It will cut down on soreness. It will cut down on cramping. And it'll cut down on muscle pulls.
You do it, right?
Well, of course I do it.
Right.
So everybody does it.
Right. So
I just did it, and I'm ready to do it again.
Exactly. I'm glad somebody
caught on. Oh, my God. I'm going to do it. I did it. I'm dead. I am dead. All right. Look, G, if you're going to prescribe a workout, you cannot skip the stretching and the interim and the rest between all this stuff.
Well, correct. Yeah, and I talked about the rest. I mean, you know, I mean.
No, you didn't.
Get your water, get your air. I mean, I didn't talk about stretching.
Oh, my God.
I mean, my God. Do I have to hold everybody's hand all the way?
Yes, you do.
Well, she's actually just wanting you to hold her hand. I'm just saying.
With great power comes great responsibility, my man.
Same thing with great legs.
Yeah.
Did you see the picture of Leslie's legs?
Yeah. All right. We got 7 minutes to talk about
my
legs.
I was talking about her legs, not mine.
We have 7 minutes to talk about my legs.
They go all the way up until I couldn't see anymore.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. Obscure movie reference, Hot to Trot. Let It Ride. With Jennifer Tilly in it. Those are some nice legs. Thanks. I just had them lengthened. They go from my ass all the way down.
That's right.
I forgot about that line.
Oh, that's a great line.
That's a good movie. It's an underrated movie. And yes, I do mean Let It Ride, not that piece of crap Hot to Trot with Bobcat Goldthwait.
Thank you.
Which is basically the same movie.
Well, nothing's the same with Bobcat in it.
Yeah.
Yeah, you know.
Let's set some couches on fire. So, Rick, what do you got?
Yeah, Rick.
After that, I need a ride in an ambulance just listening.
I was going to say, I need a nap. What are you bringing to the party this week, Rick?
I brought the baby of the month. What else am I supposed to do? What, do I got to hold everybody's hand? I mean, damn.
Hey, and you know what? You know what? And for that, you win.
That is, yes. Yeah, that was a great idea.
It really was.
So, I mean, other than that, I really don't have much as far as toxic masculinity stuff. Other than, you know, we did pass around that article earlier that says if you're in your 70s, old, fat, overweight, drink and love coffee, you're going to live forever. So I'm getting an early start because I'm only 46 and I'm already there. So I'm going to be immortal.
I actually read the article. This total great counterpoint to G's workout. So if you're in your 70s, overweight, and you drink coffee and alcohol daily, you have a great chance of
you
living
guys,
into your
90s. I have some quality shit to say about this, to be honest with you.
Okay, lay it on me.
All right, what do we have, 3 minutes?
Yeah, we got about three because we got to do the changeover.
All right, here's the thing. I believe, and I study science. I study science and I study health. I believe that our medical science is revealing that there is a more deep connection between, you know, our mental and emotional lives and our biological lives. All right. Also, I believe that from my studies that irritation and like acidity is in people's bodies can contribute to disease. So I think that please bring me on as the babe of the month another time and I'll be more comprehensive about this, but I believe that if you live a chill life and you just relax, that and if your coffee or your booze helps you with that, yes, that will help you live longer.
Yeah, I totally agree with that. I have this conversation with my octogenarian mother all the time. And whenever she's
like, right.
Hey, did you see that, you know, if I do this, it's like, well, yeah, okay. You give up all your meat, your breads, your everything, and you just eat greens. And yeah, your body may be healthy, but are you really is that a life that you want to have? Or do you want to have your chocolate chip cookies and your, you know, your glass of wine at night and your coffee in the morning? Well, listen, you've already made it to 80. Just coast. Enjoy the rest of the ride.
Right. I can't do this forever.
Right.
I don't intend to.
I hope not.
So we're all in agreement.
Yeah.
Let it ride.
Let it ride.
And it's, dudes, I am so tired tonight. I can't articulate the brilliant thing that I wanted to bring to you. Too tired. Can't articulate it. Next. When you hit me up for the babe of the month in 6 months, then I'll let you know then.
Absolutely.
That works for me.
Hey, and just as a closing shot.
Yep.
Nice legs.
Leslie, where can people find you?
Twitter, hashtag LADOWD. And I am newly posting on the Loftus Party website. And doing voice work for KLRN Radio.
Yeah.
All right, folks. All right. Well, thanks. Go ahead, Ordy.
I was just going to thank her for joining us, but you just go ahead and step all over that, Rick.
I was about to do the same thing. Thanks, Leslie, for being our first and our inaugural Babe of the Month. We'll have you on again soon. For everybody hanging out, FUBAR's coming up next. That's going to do it for the second episode of Toxic Masculinity, so stay tuned. For those hanging out in the chat, I am going to drop the link here in just a second right after we shut down so you guys know where to go. So hang tight, click that link, and we'll be right back. See you guys
in a minute. That's right, you know where to go. 25 flows. I got 25. Diamonds in my ring, 25 12s in the trunks to bang. Oh, Lord, making moves, making 25 mil.